DPReview recently put out a video where they compare the preamps from a bunch of popular hybrid systems. In their tests, the Sony A7 III did horribly, and was significantly worse than the rest when it comes to signal-to-noise ratio. Since that video came out, I received dozens of requests for me to comment on that result, and today that's exactly what I'm going to do. Let's get Undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and... Alright, so I've got two cameras in front of me here, the S1H, which that DPReview video found to be the best preamps of the lot, and the Sony A7 III, which was clearly the worst. Let's pull up a clip from the video in question so you can hear the results they got on the S1H and the A7 III for noise.
Wash your hands often to stay healthy. You can help yourself and your loved ones stay healthy by washing your hands often, especially during these key times when you are likely to get and spread germs.
Now, as many of you pointed out, something sounds wrong with that A7 III. I record internally on Sony all the time, and I definitely would have made a video about it by now if I thought it sounded that bad. But let's do some testing. So connecting to each of the cameras, I have the same microphone, which is the Rode VideoMic NTG, and both are set to the same gain knob setting of 7. For the camera settings, I have the gain turned down almost all the way. On the Sony, that means setting the gain to 1, because 0 is off and records nothing. And on the S1H, I have the gain set to -12 dB and the low option. Now, this camera can go down to -18 dB though, and we'll test that afterwards, but I put it at -12 because it more closely matched the output of the Sony, and the other Panasonic cameras can't go any lower than -12, like the S1 and the GH5, so I thought this was a more fair test. And then I just press record on each of the cameras and record the audio internally to an SD card. And if I talk a little bit louder, then we hit -12 right on, and that's using -12 dB on the low setting on the S1H, and using 1 volume on the Sony. That's as low as the Sony goes. So here we go, here's a little bit of silence to check out the noise level. And if I talk a little bit louder, then we hit -12 right on, and that's using -12 dB on the low setting on the S1H, and using 1 volume on the Sony. That's as low as the Sony goes. So here we go, here's a little bit of silence to check out the noise level. So the first thing you're going to notice here is that the giant disparity between the two cameras the DPReview captured is gone. In fact, if I look a little closer and measure the loudness of the noise sections, we find that the S1H is actually about 2 dB noisier than the A7 III. And personally, as much as I like the S1H's preamps and agree with DPReview that they're excellent, I think the A7 III sounded a little bit better here, at least on my voice, offering a bit of a richer sound and more clarity, in my opinion. Now let's try it again, but giving the Sony a slight disadvantage. Normally I record with the Sony set to 5, which could potentially introduce more noise if the preamps are really that terrible. And let's turn the S1H down all the way to its -18 dB setting.
The Sony A7 III is set to 5 on the gain, and the microphone is also set to 5, and the Panasonic S1H is set to -18 low, and the microphone is set to 10. The Sony A7 III is set to 5 on the gain, and the microphone is also set to 5, and the Panasonic S1H is set to -18 low, and the microphone is set to 10. I'll leave a moment of silence so that we can hear what the noise sounds like starting now.
Surprisingly, I found the results to be the same as my last test. The Sony sounded better and still came in 2 dB quieter for noise. I do like that the S1H allows for such a low gain setting though. Being able to go down to the low preamp with the 18 dB is great, but the Sony at 5 gain still sounded fantastic. Now let's turn the microphones down to 2 on their gain knobs and then increase the in-camera gains until we hit around -12 dB on their meters.
Both microphones are set to 2 on their gain, which is relatively low for these Rodes. And then the Sony, I've increased the gain until I get that -12 level, which makes me put the record level at around 12 on the Sony. And then over on the Panasonic, I had to switch it up to standard from low and set the gain to... It won't let me access the menu while I'm recording, but I'm pretty sure I had to set it to -5 dB. So here's just me talking again, and then I'll give you a little bit of silence so we can check out the noise.
Again, the results remain consistent. Even when taxing the preamps more, the Sony is still 2 dB quieter and produces a richer tone with more clarity. By the way, all of the clips were normalized the same way using Audition and targeting minus 16 dB LUFS, but even before normalization, the same observations I made are present. It just requires you to turn your volume up on your headphones to hear them. Also, off camera, I did this test 3 times and tried swapping things out to make sure the results were consistent. So I tried each mic on each camera and with each cord, and the results were always the same. But before we wrap this video, there are a few things I want you to consider. First, many aspects of sound quality are subjective. You may like the way one camera sounds better on your voice and microphone more than another. And for other people, in varied listening situations, they might not even hear a difference. For me, I prefer the sound of the Sony in this situation, but I wouldn't consider the difference between the two to be big enough to talk about if I wasn't directly replying to that DPReview video. But some aspects are not subjective, like measured noise. And in this case, the Sony a7 III was objectively less noisy in each scenario, which leads me to the conclusion that something either went wrong with the Sony test in the DPReview video or something is faulty on their particular a7 III. But I'd still like to commend DPReview on their video because I think tests like that are a useful resource and not a lot of channels are doing them, and there's a lot of valuable information in that video for people that want to learn more about how their cameras record sound. I'm not making this video to rip on DPReview. I love those guys. I just wanted to calm your concerns that your Sony camera was an awful choice for audio recording, because it's not. It's perfectly fine. And in my tests, it's slightly better than even the S1H. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video entertaining, or at least helpful. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, try setting your playback speed to 75%. Alright, I'm done.